Good morning, sir.
Okay, so let me share the screen now. Where is it? Okay, so today your theoretical chapters, that is module 1, 2, 3, 4, and 6 will be completed. Okay, I am leaving the module 5, right? Because if you start studying that, then you will face some problem. Okay. So mainly focus on the other 5 chapters. Okay. I will give all the documents or the PDFs in Google Classroom. Okay. So go through them. And if I get time, then I will obviously take that class. Okay. Based on your module 5, that is the power converters. Okay, check whether the screen is visible or not.
Yes, sir, visible.
Visible, sir.
Visible, no? Okay, okay, good. Okay, so in earlier classes, the switch gear, different types of switch gears, the MCCB, RCCB, ELCB, all those were discussed. Okay, and before that, I have shown you the three-phase induction motor. Okay, that is three-phase machine. So now in this session, we will discuss this single-phase induction motor. Okay, where did you see that single-phase induction motor? In your ceiling fan. Okay, the motor that is used in your ceiling fan, that is one type of single phase induction motor. Okay, so we will only study its construction, right? How it is producing the torque, right? Next, based on which theory the rotor rotates in single phase induction motor. Okay, and there are two types of theory, these two types. Okay, next, why the single phase induction motor is not self starting? The other machines that I already shown you, that is DC machines, or you can say the three phase induction machine, they are self-starting, but single phase induction motor is not self-starting. So what is the reason? This question may be given in your MCQ type of 2 marks. Okay, next, the comparison between single phase and three phase induction motor. Then what are the starting process? What is the starting process of single phase induction motor, right? So this is the introduction part. Okay, what is the single phase induction motor? So just like the three phase induction motor, it has a stator, it has a rotor, their constructional parts are almost same, right? They are almost same, but not fully, right? In single phase induction motor is structurally similar to the three phase induction motor, but what is the difference? Difference is in only stator winding arrangement. Okay, now the stator windings in this single phase induction motor are fully distributed, right? And I have shown you the skewing process. Okay, the aluminium bars are connected, they are not connected in a straight line manner, they are just tilted. Okay, like this, they are just tilted, right? And why this skewing is done? To reduce the humming, to reduce the magnetic locking, right? Now this single phase induction motors are usually small sized motors, right, of fractional kilowatt rating. Now they find wide application in fans, okay, washing machines, refrigerator, pump, lifting pump. Okay, I hope some maximum of you have that lifting pump at home, okay, with which you lift water to your
tanks.
Okay, so that pump, in that pump, that we use the single phase induction motor. Okay, now what is the construction? Construction is almost same with the three phase motor, but what is the difference in stator winding arrangement? See here, this is the stator slots. Okay, and inside it, this is the stator. Okay, this is your rotor, and this one is your shaft. Okay, now in single phase induction motor has laminated iron core. Why lamination is done? To reduce the eddy current loss. Okay, always remember this answer. Why lamination is done? To reduce eddy current loss. Reduce the eddy current loss. Okay, now these windings are arranged perpendicularly, okay, in two types. One is main winding, another one is auxiliary winding. This is the main constructional part. Okay, in three phase induction machine there is no auxiliary winding, right? But here in single phase induction motor, to start that much, to start the rotation of the rotor, we need this auxiliary winding. Okay, and this main winding and auxiliary winding are placed at 90 degree space difference. Okay, now this motor uses a squirrel cage rotor which has laminated iron core and with slots in it. See, there are also slots. This one. Okay, there are many slots where armature windings are placed. Okay, now single phase induction motor are very similar. They are composed of mainly squirrel cage rotor and a stator. Obviously, the stator carries the main winding which creates the NS pole, right? It also carries the smaller auxiliary winding that only operates during the brief period to start that motor. Okay, now this is the process of production of torque. Now from the study of three phase induction motor, it is seen that three phase distributed stator windings set up a rotating magnetic field. Okay, because this is one pole. Okay, here there is one pole in case of three phase machine. Okay, there is another. So like this, three phase windings are wound around the pole. Okay, and when the current passes through that, electromagnetic lines will be created. That means the magnetic lines of force will be there, and based on the production of N S pole, the rotor rotates. Okay, that is the main process of induction motor, the three phase induction motor. But in single phase induction motor, there are two windings. One is main winding, another one is auxiliary winding, right? Now there is only single field winding excited with the alternating current, and therefore in case of single phase induction motor, it is not inherently self-starting since it does not have any true revolving field. Okay, here three phase supply is given. Okay, this is your R phase, this is your Y phase, this is your B phase. Okay, three phase supply is given and it produces the revolving magnetic field. That's why the three phase induction rotor rotates. Okay, but here in the single phase induction motor, there is no revolving magnetic field. There is no scope for production of revolving magnetic field, because see, this is the winding, Okay, this is the main winding, right? So this is your N, this is your S, suppose, right? And in between these two poles, there is the rotor, right? And in this rotor, if you check that there are armature slots here, 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 like this. Okay, if you check that, you will see that in these windings, the force that is produced for the upper half, for the upper half section, the torque is, that means the rotating force is downward. Okay, and for the lower windings, the rotating force is upward. So basically, the clockwise torque and anti-clockwise torque, they basically cancels out each other. Okay.
Sir, someone is eating.
Okay, let me check. No, there is no one. Okay, so that is the main reason that the true revolving field is not generated, and due to this cancellation of the total torque, the squirrel cage rotor basically it vibrates. Okay, it doesn't rotate at one direction. Okay, so that's why we need this auxiliary winding. Okay, and now someone is here. Yes. Okay, so that is the reason that the single phase induction motor does not self start. Okay, now that is written already here. Okay, with reference to the figure, when sinusoidal current is flowing to the field winding, neglecting the saturation effect, the armature, the flux through armature will vary sinusoidally, right? And the magnetic field created at the particular instant of time will reverse during the next half cycle of the AC supply. That means there are two stages. Since AC supply is given, okay, like this, when your supply is this type, when your supply is positive half cycle, then your torque production is like this, okay. So ultimately, you will get zero torque, okay? And in negative half cycle, you will see that in negative half cycle, you will see that this torque will be. Okay, that will be also same direction. Okay, that will also will be in this type. Okay, so ultimately you will get zero torque amount. Okay, so that's why this single phase induction motor is not inherently self starting, right? So that's why the come to the third point, the direction of the rotor current as well as the torque created can also be determined by the Lenz's law. Okay, and the direction, it is apparent that the clockwise torque produced is counteracted by the counterclockwise torque. Okay, so that no motion results and the rotor just vibrates. Okay, because this rotor doesn't understand which direction it will move, clockwise direction or anti-clockwise direction, because the net torque that is created in this rotor is zero. Okay, so now when the rotor is made to rotate by auxiliary means in one direction, then it continues running in that direction. Okay, suppose I just add one auxiliary winding, then that auxiliary winding will produce another magnetic field, okay, and that magnetic field will tend to rotate the rotor in either direction, okay, either clockwise direction or anti-clockwise direction. Okay, now to explain this rotation, there are two theories. Okay, that two theories name only are important, their details are not basically needed, right? Revolving field theory and cross field theory. There are two theories based on which we can explain the rotation of the single phase induction motor. Okay, it is revolving field theory and the cross field theory. Now, why single phase induction motor is not self-starting? It is also written here, right? And I already told you that, already I explained. Now, what is the difference between single phase and three phase induction motor? The single phase induction motor, that is the first difference. Single phase induction motors are simple in construction, reliable and economical for small power rating as compared to the three phase induction motor, because three phase induction motors are of high power rating, right? Second, the electrical power factor for single phase induction motor is low as compared to the three phase induction motors, and also for single phase induction motors the sizes are small with respect to three phase, right? Next, the starting torque for single phase induction motor is low with respect to three phase induction motor. Next, the efficiency of single phase induction motor is also less with compared to the three phase induction machine. And based on construction, you can also say that this point this one the stator slots, okay, there are two types of winding. One is main winding, another one is auxiliary winding, but in case of three phase induction motor there is no auxiliary winding. Okay, so you can say there is another difference, that is main winding plus auxiliary winding in single phase induction motor, and for three phase induction motor there is no auxiliary winding. There is no need. Okay, now what are the starting processes? The split phase method, shaded pole method and a reluctant start method. Okay, total three types of starting, and in split phase method there are four types: split phase resistance start, split phase capacitor start, third capacitor start, capacitor run and permanent single capacitor induction motor. Okay, so in case of this single phase induction motor, only two or three questions may be given. Okay, this one, the comparison. Next, why the single phase induction motor is not self-starting? This is also important. Okay, and in short question, this question may be given. Okay, this question may be given. Okay, I hope you have seen the fans in the train. Okay, sometimes it just stops rotating. Okay, when just one person just took out one pin and rotate it at one direction, then it starts. Okay, that fan is also one type. That fan is also this of single phase induction motor. Okay, when that person gives a jerk to the blades, that moves the rotor in a particular direction. Okay, if you give the jerk in clockwise direction, then that fan will rotate in clockwise direction, and if you rotate in anti-clockwise direction, it will keep on rotating at that direction, because their auxiliary windings were weak. Okay, so with this your single phase induction motor is completed. Now next topic is synchronous machine. Okay, now the synchronous machine, or you can say the synchronous generator, that is commonly known as alternator, it is in your syllabus. Okay, now this machine is mainly used for the generation of electrical power. Okay, it generates the alternating voltage, it is stepped and transmitted. Okay, just like the other electrical machines, this generator also, this synchronous machine also has two main components, that is the stator and rotor. Okay, but there is one difference. Okay, there is one difference. In three-phase induction motor, you have seen that the field winding is placed in stator. Okay, and the armature winding is placed in the rotor. Okay, but this case, the synchronous machine, its armature winding is placed in the stator. It is just the opposite. Okay, and field winding is placed in the rotor. It is fully different. Okay, this thing you have to remember. In case of synchronous machine, the field winding is kept in rotor. Okay, and armature winding is placed in the stator. Okay, now here when the rotor is supplied with mechanical energy by coupling, prime mover engine or turbine, it generates the electrical energy in the stator. Okay, now the synchronous generator rotates at a particular fixed speed, that is called the synchronous speed. That three-phase induction machine never rotates at synchronous speed. It is always less than the synchronous speed. Okay, but in case of synchronous machine, it always rotates at synchronous speed. Okay, what is the value? 120 F by P. Okay, now it is also called the doubly excited AC machine, because the field winding is always energized from a DC source. Okay, in addition to the mechanical energy input to the rotor. Okay, So what is the difference between three phase induction machine and synchronous machine? Till now you learned that in induction machine, field winding is placed in the stator and armature winding is placed in the rotor. But in case of synchronous machine, the field winding is placed in the rotor and armature winding is placed in the stator, and we get the electrical output from the stator. Okay, and here we always need a DC source to energize the field winding. Okay, this DC source that is energizing the field winding, it is called the excitation. Okay, it is called excitation. Until unless you excite the field winding, this mechanical energy to the electrical energy conversion won't be possible in case of synchronous generator. Okay. Now, the synchronous generator is of three phase system. Okay. So, it is obviously the self-starting, right? Until there is no need for the auxiliary winding, just like the single phase induction motor. Okay, so there may be 2, 4, 6 poles, and three phase windings A, B, C are placed in the stator slots. Okay, and the coils are obviously 120 degree to each other with their axis. Okay, so now this is the synchronous speed calculation for the synchronous machine. Okay, always remember that synchronous machine rotates at synchronous speed, but three phase induction machine never rotate at synchronous speed, because if that rotate, if that starts rotating at synchronous speed, then the relative speed will become zero and there will be no generation of EMF, and hence there will be no flow of current also. Okay. Now this is the construction: frame, stator, core. All are just same. The stator core is made of thin laminations of highly permeable steel in order to reduce the iron loss. Okay, and it also carries the alternating flux and houses the stator winding. Right. The axial length of the stator core is comparatively short in case of synchronous machine for low speed and large diameter generators. Okay, the axial length or high speed generators having 2 or 4 poles that can be many times its diameter. Okay, these generators require forced air circulation for cooling. Next, the stator winding. The stators of the synchronous generators are wound with 3 distinct and independent windings to generate the 3-phase power. Okay, since we are giving the 3-phase supply, so 3-phase power output is natural. Now, usually the stator windings material is made of high conductivity copper. Okay, and just like the 3-phase induction motor, the stages of power generation is also same. Okay, there will be stator loss, there will be rotor copper loss, there will be friction and winding loss and windage loss. All that losses you have to subtract from the input. Okay, the 3 stator windings are exactly like in shape and they are displaced from each other exactly at 120 degree electrical, so that the induced EMF in the windings are 120 degree in time phase. Okay. Now these 3-phase windings are either connected in star or in delta. It's up to the manufacturer. Okay. In case of star, what is the main calculation? That is line voltage equals to root 3 into phase voltage, right? It is for the star connection. We denote it by the letter capital Y, and I line will be equals to I phase, right? And for delta, VL will be equals to V phase, and IL will be equals to root 3 into I phase. Okay, now next, the double layer winding is often used to wind to wound the armature of a synchronous generator. Okay, next, this one is the rotor. Okay, there are two types of synchronous machine based on their construction. Okay, one is called the cylindrical rotor. Okay, another one is salient cone. Total two types of synchronous machines are there. One is cylindrical type synchronous machine. Okay, another one is salient cone synchronous machine. Okay, now the rotor is built from solid steel forging. Chromium nickel steel or chromium nickel molybdenum steel is used to prepare to construct this kind of rotor. Okay, now they are what are the differences between the cylindrical rotor and the salient type? In cylindrical rotor, they are smaller in diameter but their axial length is large. Okay, the number of poles in the rotor is mainly 2 or 4. Their operating speed is high because 120 F by P. Since in this kind of machine, cylindrical rotor type machine, your value of P is less, that's why their synchronous speed, the P value, if it is less, then their synchronous speed is higher. Okay, the windage loss is also less. The rotor is subjected to high mechanical stress due to the high peripheral speed. Okay, now they are mechanically more balanced than the salient cone type. Okay, now what are the features for salient cone type? They are larger in diameter but smaller in axial length, just opposite of the cylindrical machine. Okay, the pole shoes are wide and usually cover 2/3 of the pole. Now these machines are suitable for only low and medium speed. Okay, whereas the cylindrical rotor type machines are for high speed. Right. Now, it is different types of synchronous machines. What are their ratings? It is written here. Okay. Now, modern synchronous machines are rated for 6.6 kV, that means high voltage. Okay. If armature winding is placed in the rotor, 3 slip rings, each capable of handling huge current, are required. Okay, and each slip ring must be properly insulated from the shaft of high voltage. Moreover, the shaft of every machine is electrically earthed. Okay, now yesterday I told you the difference between earthing and grounding. Okay, now it is easier to collect the large armature current if the armature is stationary, and the collection of large current through slip ring is difficult. Now, with a field winding on rotor, only 2 slip rings are required instead of 3 slip rings. Okay, and slip ring losses are reduced. That will give us better efficiency. Now, there are certain excitation systems. Okay, the details are not in your syllabus, but just you need to know what kinds of excitation systems are there. Okay, first one is the DC excitation system, normal DC excitation system. Here this is your field winding. Okay, and to energize that field winding, this amplidyne is used. Okay, with this system you can energize the field, that is the DC excitation system. And then next one is the AC excitation system. With the controlled rectifier, we give the controlled DC excitation output to the field. Okay. Now, next one is the static excitation. Now, here all components on this system are fully stationary, right? The stationary rectifiers supply the excitation currents directly to the field of the main synchronous generator through the slip rings. Okay, then the rectifiers are supplied from the main generator to transformer, which steps down the voltage to a particular level. Now, this type of excitation system is classified into two types: potential source controlled rectifier and compound source rectifier system. So basically three types of excitation systems are there. One is DC excitation, another one is AC excitation, and then the static excitation. Okay. Okay, so with this, your module 4 is completed, right? And so now your module 1, module 2, module 3, module 4, and module 6 are fully completed. Okay, and I am leaving the module 5. Okay, and I will upload all the notes in Google Classroom. So go through them. Okay, so thank you everyone. I am concluding today's class. All of you give your attendance in the chat box.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Sir.
Thank you, sir.
Yes?
Sir, roll number 70 is present, but he is suddenly disconnected.
Roll number 70.
Yes, sir, 70.
Okay.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Sir, what questions will be asked in Viva, sir?
Yeah, based on your practical experiments that you perform. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Thank you, sir.